Today we will solve some sums and we will discuss certain important properties of errors. Okay, so we will solve the first sum. Say it is given that if temperature of an object is T1, which is nothing but 300 plus minus 1 Kelvin. Now plus minus 1 Kelvin means whenever you see this kind of value, always remember that just after plus minus the value which is written, that is the absolute error. That is the absolute error of this temperature. Okay, so we write it by plus minus. The temperature of another object is T2, which is 500 plus minus 2 Kelvin, means 2 is the absolute error of T2. Now, what is number 1, the total temperature of the bodies, and number 2, the difference in temperature of the body. Okay, so number 1, how we will do is total temperature. So total temperature means we will add 300 with 500 gives us 800. Okay, but when we write the total temperature, we also have to mention the errors, and remember that whether it is addition or subtraction, error is always additive. Means we have done here addition, answer we got 800. In the same way, we will add both the errors also. Means 1 plus 2, it gives us 3. So final result will be like this, 800 plus minus 3. So this 3 is the absolute error in the total value. Okay. For the next case, you have to find out the difference. So to get the difference, what shall we do? We have to subtract T1 from T2. We should do this one, no? T2 minus T1 means 500 minus 300. So value comes as 200, but we have to also express the error. Just now I said that whether we add or we subtract, the error is always additive. Means first error is 1, second error is 2, total error will be 3. It is always additive. We will add it, we will not subtract. Okay, so that means our final result is difference will be 200 plus minus 3. So this is the absolute error in the difference. Okay, this much of Kelvin. Now, some formula we have here. We have 5 formulas, very important one. So see, the first 2 formula already we applied in this case. Here, if Z is equal to AB, Z means any physical quantity, which is equal to A plus B. That means A is a physical quantity, B is another physical quantity. Okay, just like this one. This capital T is nothing but like Z. T1 means A, T2 means B. So if the quantity is like this, when we add them, delta Z means it is the absolute error in Z. In Z means absolute error. If you compare it with this, absolute error in T. So how much is the absolute error in T? This is 3. Okay, so this delta Z is nothing but this 3. That should be equal to delta A. Delta A means what? It is the absolute error in the first term. First term here it is T1. So, absolute error in T1, how much was that? It was 1. So, that means delta A is 1. Plus, this is B. So, if you just compare, if this is B, that is B is nothing but T2. Right? And delta B will be error in B. So, error in B, if this is T2, error in B is 2. Right? So, delta Z is 3, delta A is 1 plus delta B is 2. So this is one formula, and this formula in the first case we have already applied. See the second formula, Z equals to A minus B. So this is nothing but the second case when we subtract. So when we subtract, delta Z means it is the error, it is the absolute error in Z. Here which one is Z? This 200 is the Z. So absolute error in Z, absolute error in A. Absolute error in A means same only. Absolute error in T1, which is 1. Absolute error in B is error in T2, which is 2. Okay, then next one. When Z, this 2 we used, this one we did not use yet. Next formula, if Z equals to A into B. So if into B, for multiplication, directly we are getting relative error, not absolute error. Okay. Absolute error we can find out, but here we are getting relative error directly. And how is that? Z equals to, when it is A into B, then delta Z by Z, this delta Z by Z is the relative error in Z. That is equal to delta A by A, this is the relative error in A. plus delta b by b is the relative error in b. We will get we will have to use this formula also in some other cases, but till now we have not used this one. Next one, formula number 4. When z is, now it is division, z is a by b, then also same thing, this one, and for multiplication we wrote this one, these two are same, okay. So delta z by z is equal to delta a by a plus delta b by b. And the fifth formula is, if z equals to this, so here you can see it is a combination of multiplication and division, a b multiplied divided by c, and it has also some powers, okay. So now for this type of formula, what we will do is, z means this quantity. Now delta z by z is a relative error in z. How we express it? The power will come as coefficient. Power of a is small a. Small a will come here as coefficient. Okay. Then we will write delta a by a plus. Now it is the b's turn. So b power is what? Small b. It will come as coefficient. Delta b by b plus. Everywhere we will be putting plus only. Delta this is c is the power, so this small c will come here, and this will be delta c by c. All right. So here we got 5 formula, and one sum we have solved using the last formula. This one. If relative error in radius of a sphere is this much, find the relative error and percentage error in the volume of the sphere. So we have the formula, volume of a sphere V is equals to 4 by 3 pi r cube. Okay. So volume is 4 by 3 pi r cube. That means delta V by V. If you use this formula, remember that 4 by 3 pi being a constant, this term we are not going to consider. So what we are going to write? Delta V by V. Alright. This 3, here it is a power, but as we know, according to this formula, this power comes as a coefficient. So this 3 will come here, coefficient. And only one term we have, which is r. So r we can write delta r by r, just using this formula. Here we have 3 terms, but here we have only 1. So suppose like this only, 3 will come here as power, it was power, it will come as coefficient, delta r by r. So this delta r by r, it is the relative error in radius. So relative error in radius is how much? 0.05. So in place of this, we are going to write 0.05. Multiply, we get this value. So this is a relative error in volume. Relative error in volume is obtained. Next one is percentage error in volume. So to get percentage error, we know the formula. We will multiply this value with 100%. Okay. So if you multiply it, then we get 15%. So this is the percentage error in volume of the sphere.